Hey guys, what are you singing?
Sorry, yeah, I was.
Oh, okay.
So, like, literally, like 1 second of the intro to the song played, and then I was trying to recreate it.
Yeah. The little second we heard was Catch City. Yo, shouts to Tristan, Ethan, Jimmy, and Sean. Thanks, guys, for being the patrons and requesting this track. Born of Osiris, poster boy. So where are we at with Born of Osiris?
Traditionally, I've not been a huge fan.
Yeah, me neither. I've seen him live a bunch of times. Mm-hmm. I can't say it's not that I haven't been a huge fan. I never thought poorly of the music or the thing going on. Mm-hmm. I just never was super in. That all changed recently when I heard the song Angel or Alien, and that shit blew my mind. Mm-hmm. I was like fully on board with that track. So this, I believe, is off of the record, which is out now. I believe this was, I could be getting this wrong, but I think this was the second single for that release. So I think it was Angel or Alien, and then Poster Boy, and then the record release. Really pumped up on Angel or Alien. I thought the music video for that track and the song itself was all around amazing. Mm-hmm. I felt really bad because we checked it out on a live Twitch stream, which we do every Friday. If you guys want to come out for those live reactions, hangouts, whatever that goes on there. I was just like, I kept saying, I was like, why didn't we save this for the channel? Why didn't we save this for the channel? Why didn't we? I felt so bad because literally I was losing my head over that song.
Yeah.
It was so good. The guitar work in it, all of it, the music video, so, so cool. So because of that, we're back to check out one that we haven't checked out. In fact, when this one came out, we had it requested a few times on the stream. We were like, no. We're not making this mistake again. Mm-hmm. So here we are. And with that said, should we get into it?
Yeah, let's do it.
Poster Child, Born of Osiris. Let's check it out.
Okay, the headless girl. Guitars.
Oh yeah, tell him.
I have a problem with headless guitars. That's they it. Don't look right.
I started taking guitar lessons like a few months back, and my instructor plays like an 8-string Kiesel, and there's no headstock on it. And every time Lindsay would be walking by, I'd be on like Discord call, video call with my instructor, you know, taking my lesson. She'd get all uptight. She'd be like, what the fuck is wrong with his guitar?
I'd never noticed that was even a possibility before then.
So because of that, that became a recurring theme where now I just blow her mind with all the videos we check out. Look, no headstock. Look, no headstock. And she gets all upset about that.
It looks wrong. It looks like a man without a head.
Yo, his shirt is sick. Yo!
Jinx!
Dude, mm-hmm. That lead.
That like, meow, 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 whatever it is. Sorry, I can't do it. I never should try to replicate musical instruments with my mouth.
No, you got it. That was the one.
Okay, cool.
That was the one.
I never would have known that was a guitar.
Was it?
Well, I don't know. Like,
I don't think that was a guitar.
When it was playing in the song, a man was holding a guitar. Was he playing it?
I think that it would have been a MIDI pattern or played on a synth.
Oh, okay.
Let's listen to it.
Okay. Was it them doing it?
I don't think so.
Okay. It doesn't really sound like
is
a
that
guitar.
Guys, let us know down below. Is that a lead tone? It sounds super digital. I mean, it might be. It might just be like a really heavily affected, like a lead patch. But I think that's like some kind of synth plugin, I think. Yeah, I don't know what that. You like you got me, dude. Really great melody they wrote for that part.
Try to die. Space to me. Poster child.
with Born of Osiris in the past, like the biggest holdup for me has always been I felt like there was too much going on at one time for me to like be able to listen. But I feel like these mixes are so well done and the parts are like written very complementary of one another that there's like a lot of space for me as a listener to like pick out what's going on, which I think is really cool.
That is so interesting. That was like a perfect way to describe that effect because that definitely happens to me with some bands as well.
Really?
Yes. Like I cannot pick out really what's going on and it's just like too much coming at me at once almost.
Yeah.
And I like don't understand music, so I don't know how to interpret it.
Sometimes it's like a band's style.
Yeah.
You know, like that was Slipknot back in the day. It was like nine guys making noise in time.
Oh my God, that's actually so true. Barely in time.
Barely in time.
Barely in time.
Yeah, right?
They've got someone dancing on a drum set.
Yeah. That's one thing they did though. As time went on, like the mixes got cleaner and cleaner. The parts got cleaner and cleaner. Nowadays, like with their newer stuff, it's the first time in Slipknot history where I can actually hear the percussion drums. You know,
like they're actually like purposeful now.
Yeah, like they're actually decorative. In there. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I never heard them before. Yeah. Anyways, let's get back to this. Fuck yeah, dude. Oh my God. Oh, this is vibey. All right. No way.
Whoa. Yeah, what? Was that saxophone?
No way, the outro. Oh, that's so cool.
What? Oh my God. That's so unexpected.
So what's a poster child?
Like the poster child of something is like the most famous, well-known, like the face of that thing is what I would say.
Okay.
Yeah.
A person or thing that emphasizes or represents a specific quality, cause, etc. Like, so what does he mean? So what is the, when you know everything, like speak to me, poster child, because you know everything about the world. What would I ever do without you? Because you know everything. So what does that mean? Does that mean like?
It's like sarcastic.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. That's, now I'm starting to get it.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't sure what the poster child meant. Okay. So he's saying like, fuck off, don't tell me how to live. Essentially,
yeah, he's saying
summed
like,
up, like with a bow,
you know, like you're not actually the expert on this thing. Like,
yeah, it's kind of like live for yourself, like find your, like use your own experiences to view the world. Don't just like,
yeah,
don't
I
just
like
believe like who's ever shouting loudest.
Yeah, yeah,
that's
yeah.
The idea. Okay,
yeah,
true.
Totally.
I vibe with all that for sure.
Yeah. Think for yourself.
You'll never laugh in the same way you did. So dilute your instincts. You pretend to shake the snow globe, but say, forget the world in your misery. Always locked in the cradle feeding. How much more do you need? You refuse to take the high road. Lay the blame in yourself and not at your feet. So that's like somebody who's going to, who's just fucking preaching, but not walking the walk and is just sheltered from the world and doesn't really know.
Yeah.
It's like, how dare you how dare you like speak to things that you're just sheltered from? Like, how much do you need before you're ready to just like actually experience? That's what I'm getting. Kind of from the vibe of the song and the video. I don't know. It's a really cool song. It was all really, 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 really cool. So how many reallys? We need a really tally on screen.
Really counter.
Really counter. A lot of reallys. Yo, the breakdown, the guitar that like swelled out of the lo-fi and just hit. Oh my God. That was so awesome. That bridge hit. And then the way the chorus came back in and like it just, the way it all built, like layered by layer. And then my comments in the middle still stand with that, where like it was like such a, like the composition was put together so well. I feel like it was very, very tasteful. Mm. I feel like that would be the word. Like, I feel like in my personal opinion, their newer stuff has a certain level of taste to it. That's just like right along with what I jam, what I listen to. So,
gotcha.
Yeah.
Nice.
So I would say, I thought that was super cool. What did you think about the song? Did you dig it?
Thought it was okay.
Yeah.
It's not, I guess, like something I would normally find myself listening to.
Okay.
But I also wouldn't turn it off.
Yeah, I can see that for you.
I need a few more like listens. I think that like stuff like this is where like you being a musician and me not makes our opinions differ a little bit, is what
yeah.
I think.
Yeah. I like, I get into this vibe. I also get into like bands like Era and you're like, nope, out the building.
Yeah.
Or like Animals as Leaders, you're like, nope.
I'm pretty lukewarm about all those bands.
Polyphia, you're like, nope.
Also, yeah. Yeah.
You're like, I can't, yeah. I don't know. What the fuck are you listening to?
What's happening? What? Yeah.
This guy's been soloing for how long now?
I know. That's so true. The whole song is a fucking solo. I don't know. Like,
totally. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Orr. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed our reaction, first impressions, thoughts on the song Poster Child by Born of Osiris. Huge shout out to the patrons, Tristan, Ethan, Jimmy, and Sean, who requested this one for us to check out with all of you. If you want to become a patron, Patreon link down in the description. You can request songs that we will check out here on the channel. Thank you guys so much for checking out our videos, and we'll see you all very soon with something new.